Skywatch Media News for May the 20th, 2021. In December of 2019, the Sun entered its 25th solar cycle, and according to consensus predictions, sunspot activity was expected to ramp up in 2020 before peaking in July of the year 2025. However, for the last few years, our star has been in a slumber, with a decline in sunspot numbers, and with relatively few bright flares or massive coronal ejections emanating from its surface. That was until just recently when the Sun began heating up. On May 7th, a sunspot named AR2822 exploded, producing an M3.9 class solar flare, one of the strongest in quite some time. The solar storm caused a widespread radio blackout over North America. Although the solar flare didn't cause any noticeable damage, it still raises a question as to whether America is ready to face a major solar storm that is directed towards Earth. The probability of a solar superstorm affecting the Earth's communication systems is quite real, and we only have to look back to the year 1921 as evidence that this has already occurred. 100 years ago, on the 15th of May, 1921, a powerful geomagnetic storm caused telegraph and telephone lines in the United States and from around the world to fuse out. As a result of the malfunctions, equipment was damaged, connections were severed, and undersea telegraph cable service was interrupted. Auroras appeared as far south as Southern California, making the night sky so bright in Boston that you could read a newspaper. As a result of the superstorm, the railroad switching system in New York was destroyed, and so the event became known as the New York Railroad Superstorm of 1921. Earth was hit hard by CME solar flares for 3 consecutive days back then, which weakened and then penetrated the Earth's natural defenses. An event similar or greater in magnitude is expected to take place again, and when it does, the after effects will make the recent pandemic seem like a walk in the park. And so, we must be ready. One of the most vulnerable systems at risk is our global positioning system. The GPS signals have been incorporated into virtually every network technology on the planet, including telecommunications, the internet, ATMs, and credit card transactions. The electronic equipment on board these satellites is very sensitive and can be easily damaged or destroyed by incoming solar flares, and so their security is a high priority. GPS satellites are positioned 12,000 miles above the Earth, where they circle the globe twice a day. This makes them defenseless against a powerful solar event. If the GPS shuts down, it could easily become a single point of failure for America and for much of the world, creating a state of economic and security chaos. Yet despite the vulnerabilities and the threats posed by severe solar activity, the U.S. has thus far failed to implement an alternative plan in the event of a GPS malfunction. Without a doubt, the powerful CMEs are a recurring phenomenon, and they are a looming danger to our planet. The first recorded event of its danger took place during the Carrington event of September 1859, with the burning of telegraph communications as well as the remarkable night skies, where auroras migrated far into the tropics. It was a brief moment in time in which the sun touched the earth. In our recent past, a powerful CME passed through the Earth's orbit, which, if it had occurred several days earlier, would have impacted Earth. Solar events like this one are not as rare as once thought. Most recently, The deputy director of the National Center for Atmospheric Research concluded that the next 10 years will be a particularly dangerous time, possibly the most active period since the 1970s. A particular concern is the GPS. Within the next decade, there is a 35 to 45% chance that a CME will disrupt GPS service across the globe for many days or even weeks. Even more concerning is the chance of a Carrington-level solar flare this decade, which has a 4 to 12% likelihood of taking place. Granted, these are estimates, and it's always a possibility that the scenario will never play out, at least in our lifetime. But the damage to America, if it were to occur, would be difficult to comprehend, since we are behind the eight ball when it comes to alternative forms of telecommunications in the event of a GPS breakdown. You would think that government preparations would be a high priority when combating existential threats from space. They have known about the threat for years, but have been slow to act. A plan to have a terrestrial backup of our GPS systems in the event of a catastrophic failure has been in the works since the year 2004, and yet nothing has ever been done to fully secure the technology. Yet even with the most concerted government efforts, it would not be enough to make us safer from solar storms, since it would require at least 5 or 6 years to establish systems and protect vital services, which would take us well into the upcoming solar danger zone. Every day becomes a ticking time bomb, and so we must act, and do so quickly before time runs thin. 2021 has been a very active year for meteor and fireball events in our sky. There has also been a noticeable increase in the number of asteroid close encounters coming within one lunar distance of the Earth. Let's have a look at some of the reported events in our sky for the week of May 13th. A newly discovered asteroid designated 2021 JU6 flew past Earth at a distance of just 40,900 miles from the center of our planet on May the 14th. 2021 JU6 was first observed at Palomar Mountain Observatory in California on May the 14th, on the same day it made its close approach to our planet. The object belongs to the Apollo group of asteroids, and it has an estimated diameter between 29 and 65 feet. This now becomes the 57th known asteroid to fly by Earth within one lunar distance since the start of the year, and it is also the sixth so far for the month of May, outpacing the numbers for this time last year. There are moments in time when confronted with feelings of uneasiness that we begin to doubt our purpose in life. And yet, despite the uncertainty, take heart in knowing that every life is unique and it happens only once. In the infinite realm of the universe, there will never be another you. Stay safe, everyone. Thanks for watching. And always keep looking to the sky.